Assalamu alaikum everyone, this is Mohammad Sohrab and you are watching EvolveSage Virtual Learning. Guys, if you want to do research but you do not know how to start it or what is the first step and the step that you will take after the first step, then stay connected with me during this video, because in this video I am going to explain a very fundamental and very essential topic of research, which is research process. So let's go to our today video. Before discussing your research process, we should know what is actually research. As I said in my previous video, that research contains on two words. One is re and then second is search. Okay, re mean again and again, and search mean finding something. So here in the research, we find something again and again. Okay, and we find the solution of a problem, and we find the knowledge related to a phenomena. Okay, increase the knowledge related to existing phenomena. Okay, so definitely if we want to find the solution of a problem, there will be some steps and there will be a systematic way through which we will proceed toward the solution. Okay, so these systematic process, these systematic steps called as research process. Okay, so what is actually research process? Research process mean from beginning to the end, which steps you will follow to find the solution of your problem. Okay, one thing you guys should keep in your mind, that in research we follow systematic approach for finding the solution of a problem. Systematic approach mean that we can't do second step unless we do the first one. Okay, so here in research we follow a systematic approach toward finding the solution of a problem, toward creating knowledge related to existing phenomena. So now let's discuss research process. Research process means which steps we follow from beginning to the end, okay, for finding the solution of a problem. So let's discuss these steps. Guys, first step is formulation of problem. Formulation of problem means you identify your problems, find the question that has no existing answer. Okay, and every good research began with a question. Okay, every good research began with a question. So first step of research is identification of problem or formulation of problem. For example, at present there is no curable medicine for HIV or AIDS. Okay, so this is our problem, and you select this topic as topic of your research. And second step in research process is review of literature. What does review of literature mean? You find the maximum knowledge that exists related to your problem. Okay, you find the maximum knowledge that is exists related to your problem, and you find knowledge related to your problem from different books, okay, from different articles, magazines, and through internet. Okay, you find the maximum knowledge that exists related to your problem. Okay, so that you can understand your problem well. So here we collect maximum knowledge. Okay, and it could be possible that we find the half solution of our problem, and furthermore we add the finding of our knowledge and we contribute in that knowledge. Okay, so this is called research gap. We will discuss it later. So it could be possible that through research review, literature review, you may be find the maximum knowledge that you have required to solve your problem. Okay, then you can put your findings in that knowledge and make it a full and final solution for a problem. In research we call it gap identification. Okay, we will discuss it later in more detail, but for now you have to understand that it is very essential for us to find maximum knowledge related to our phenomena. Okay, it is very essential in research. The third step of research process is formulation of hypothesis. So here you formulate your hypothesis. So let's understand what actually hypothesis is. Hypothesis means it is the assumptions, expectations, and imaginations of researcher. Researcher is the person who is doing research, okay? He is expecting that this will be the result, okay? On the basis of his assumptions, on the basis of his expectation, he writes some hypothesis and he expects that his results will be as per these hypotheses. And it could be wrong or it could be right, but he expects that final result will be that, okay? So here how we formulate hypothesis. And he do assumptions on the basis of literature review, because in the literature review, in step 2, he has studied the maximum knowledge, he has gained the maximum knowledge, and he studied maximum topics related to his topic, his study. So finally he assumed that his results will be like this, okay? But it is not necessary that his results follow the pattern of literature review, okay? Maybe there will be a new solution, but yeah, and maybe the solution will be more different than the literature review, whatever he has studied in different articles and in different books, because it depends on the population he is selecting, it depends on the sample size he is collecting, it depends on the methods he is adopting, or it depends on the time duration as well. Guys, fourth step is research design. Research design mean the overall plan of the researcher to conduct the research. So research plan mean the overall plan of the researcher to conduct the research, okay? It contain on many steps, and I will make a separate video to define every step that exists in research design. But for right now, you all need to understand that research design means overall plan that you follow during the research, okay? And during the finding of your population, during the finding of your sample size. Okay guys, fifth step is specification of population, okay? What does specification of population mean? When you are conducting your research, you have to identify the population. In specification of population, you have to identify which population you are going to conduct your research. On which population you are going to conduct your research. Like if you are going to conduct research on COVID-19, definitely your population will be COVID-19 patients, okay? And in the same way, if you are going to conduct the research on students, okay, then you are research, your population of research will be your students, okay? In the same way, if you are going to conduct the research on the economy of a country, then the economy of that country will be your population, okay? The research population means people whom your research will affect, okay? And who consider your research to be necessary for to be conducted, okay? And who consider your research is necessary to be conducted, and who has required the solution of a problem, okay? The people who are facing problem, and the people who have required knowledge, and people who want to answer of a question will be considered as your population, okay? You are conducting your research for only for those areas, okay? For those groups. Sixth step is sample selection, okay? Sample mean a small part of whole, okay? The population which you have selected, now you will study on that population. So here in sample, the small number of people represent the whole population. Like in a country, maybe a million of people are COVID patients, but out of those millions, we will select 100, 200, 300 for our sample only, and these 300 will represent the rest of whole population. So this is how we select our sample, okay? And this sample is used for data collection, okay? And this sample is used for experiment, okay? On the basis of this sample, we actually conduct our required data, and from this sample we conduct our required data, required information, okay, and then we provide a solution on the basis of this sample, and on the basis of this sample we do analysis. Seventh step is ethical consideration. Okay, ethical consideration means you have to conduct your research legally. Okay, if you are conducting your research in a school, definitely you have to require get permission from the school authorities and get permission from the parents of the children's, okay, from the parents of the students. Okay, in the same way, if you are conducting a research in hospital, definitely you required permission from government, you required permission from authorities of that hospitals, and you required permission from the patients. You have to respect their rights, and you have to maintain their privacy. Okay guys, eighth step is pilot study. Pilot study mean rough study. Okay, before going to conduct research, you have to do a rehearsal. Okay, you do some rehearsal, you check whether it is possible for you to conduct this research or not. Is this possible for you to conduct the data that is required to you? Okay, so all the, so before research we do some rehearsals. Okay, like if there is a program going to organize in your university, definitely before that program you do some rehearsals. Okay, 1 or 2 days before you do some rehearsal, you try to identify the problems that exist, that can be exist during that day. So before that you do some rehearsals. In the same way, when we conduct research, we do some rehearsal, we do pilot study to find the problems that can create some difficulties for you during your studies. Okay, you have to find out those problems. Okay guys, another very essential step is data collection. Okay, what is data collection? Data collection is the process of collecting information related to your population, and but you collect that information from your sample, selected sample. Okay, so there are many ways we can collect our information. We can distribute questionnaire in our selected samples. Okay, and we can conduct some interviews. Okay, and we can gather them in a group, and we can collect data on the basis of observations, on the basis of feedback. So this is a different scenarios, and this is the different patterns of collecting data, and it totally depends on the research that you are going to do. Okay, okay, definitely if the research is for medical purposes, definitely that process of data collecting will be different. Okay, if our research is going to conduct it for management sciences students, if research is conducted by management sciences students, definitely they follow different pattern of collecting data. Like if they are conducting a research on economy, definitely they will get necessary information that is available on different platforms. Okay, so this is the process of data collection. Mean necessary information that you will use, and on the basis of that data we will use some techniques, methods, and we will find our solution on the basis of that data. So it is very essential for us to have a very accurate data, and a data that is that has no biasness. Guys, 10th very essential step is data analysis and interpretations. Okay, so unless we have data, we can't do analysis. Okay, unless we do analysis, we can't find a solution. Okay, so it is very essential that we perform some analysis and we find the solution of our problem. Okay, once we have data, then we will use different techniques, we will use different analysis. Okay, analysis can be done through different available softwares like SPSS, ANOVA and Smart PLS. So these are the different different softwares which mostly used in analysis. Definitely, again I'm saying that if research is for medical purposes, definitely that research will be examined in laboratories. Okay, data will be examined in laboratories. Okay, so the data related to that research will be examined in laboratories. Okay, after analyzing data, after conducting, after performing some methods, okay, techniques, we will have some results. Okay, and then on the basis of those results, we will do some interpretations. What actually these results indicates. Okay, in data analysis and tech interpretations, we do we perform some analysis and we do some interpretation on examined results. And last and very essential step of research process is inclusion or communicating finding to population. It is very essential and very needy step that we follow in research. And so now in conclusion, you provide your finding to your audience because they are your target audience. And how you can communicate results to the audience or result to the population, you can do this through magazines, you can do this through writing books, and you can do this by publishing your research papers. Okay, so this was all about from today's session. In next session, we will discuss research design in detail, and we will discuss data collection in more detail and how we can do or how we can perform different analysis.